Namaste everyone and welcome to Comfy Meal. So today I am going to share with you the diet chart of a 4 month old baby. So firstly, let me tell you, if your baby is 4 months old, it is not at all necessary that you have to see this video and start solids for your baby. Starting solids for your baby may vary from age to age, from baby to baby. And you need to assess for your baby when it is the right time for your baby to start with solids. For this, I have a very detailed video on my page. You can go see it, assess if your baby is ready or not, and then make a decision whether or not you want to start with solids. So if you are a parent and you want to start solids for your baby and your baby is 4 months of age, then please watch this video till the end. If your baby is a little older, your baby is of 5 months, 6 months of age, then please see those age appropriate videos, because some discussions, some points in this video may not be applicable to you or your baby. So please see age specific videos. All of them are there on my page. And let's start today's video for a 4 month baby. I have made some notes that I'm going to share with you all. So I will break this video down into 7 parts so that it is much more clear and easy for you to understand. So I will be discussing what kind of foods to give to your baby, what foods to give, how much to give, at what time you can give, what are the foods that you should not give, what will be the milk and water schedule after starting solids, and the last one would be any other changes that you can expect in your baby's body after starting solids. So let's take the first point. What is the kind of food that you can give to your baby? So here, please remember that whatever food you are giving to your baby should be very similar to the milk that your baby has been drinking. So till now, your baby must have been drinking only breast milk or formula milk. So your food should also be very similar to that in terms of its consistency, texture, and temperature. So consistency means it should neither be too thick nor should it be too runny. Okay, the second thing is texture. It should not have textures like grains of dal should not be there. Everything should be well blended and smooth. Don't give rice directly. Otherwise, your baby's initial experience of food would be really negative, and then your baby will not be able to cooperate with the whole procedure. Then the third thing is temperature. So the milk that your baby has been drinking is generally at room temperature or maybe a little warm. So please try to keep your food also at those temperatures. Don't give anything too cold or too hot also. Otherwise, of course, there is a risk of burning, but otherwise also it would not be a great experience for your baby. So try to keep the foods very, very similar to what your baby has been used to. So the second question is, what are the foods that come in this criteria? What foods can you give? So in this, what you can give is thinned down purees of fruits or vegetables, dals or juices. These are three very good things that you can give at 4th month. So when I am talking about purees, thinned down purees, what you can do is you can take any vegetables or fruits like apples, pears, carrots, anything, make a puree of it, put more water in it and then thin it down completely, and then maybe you can give it to your baby. Juices you can give of any seasonal fruit or vegetable like carrots, apple, pear, pomegranate, mango, or any seasonal fruit or vegetable that you have in your area. And dals you can give. You can make any light dal. It should not be too heavy like chana or udar. It can be any light dal like moong or red masoor dal. And you can just make it with a little more water than normal. Blend it or run it through a mixer so that it turns completely smooth, and then you can give it to your baby. You do not need to separate the dal and give only water, because then a lot of nutrition will go away with the dal, and it is not needed also, because dal is really good and it is very easy to digest. If your baby is ready for solids, then your baby will be able to digest these light dals also, so don't worry about it. These things you can give, and based on my personal feeling and recommendation and experience also, I believe that fruit is a very good option to start with, especially apple. Apple is very light, very easy to digest. It is very simple to make and it has a very nice, delicious, sweet taste to it. So your baby will have a very good experience in having apple. And if you give something too bland like dal in the beginning, then your baby might not have a very great experience of it. So You can start with fruits. That is my personal recommendation, and I have done it too. Then the third thing is how much to give. So for how much to give, you need to understand that there is no fixed guideline for it. You can take cues from your baby and then decide how much you want to give. If you are making a juice of one apple and you have this much of apple juice, or if you have this much of dal, and if you're sitting with it and one day your baby eats one spoon, one day your baby eats five spoons, one day your baby does not eat anything at all, please remember all of this is normal. All the situations are normal. Just like adults, you know, babies' choices, likes, everything keeps changing, you know. Sometimes we also don't feel like eating, sometimes we feel like eating a lot. So it keeps changing for babies also. It's completely fine, don't worry. If you have given two spoons to your baby and you think your baby wants to eat more, then please give. Don't worry, don't shy away from giving. Don't think that it will cause any troubles. Don't worry, a human body is very, very smart. Such a small body is much smarter. Okay, it knows how to take care of itself. Baby will automatically reject if he does not want to eat it, if his tummy is full. And still, if baby is eating and tummy was full, then what is the worst that can happen? Baby can spit out a bit or vomit a bit. It's absolutely fine. Don't worry. Don't panic at all. It is completely normal for babies to vomit and do these things at certain points in time. Don't worry at all. Just you can take cues from your baby and give as much as baby wants and is able to digest well. So don't worry about that. Then the next thing is at what time you can give food. So a good time to give is during the day, around 10 to 11 in the morning to 1 to 2 p.m. This is a very good time to give. At this age, you have to give only one meal in the beginning. Make the baby more used to everything. And daytime is a very good time to give these meals so that everything can get digested well. And even if, you know, in a very rare chance, there is some reaction that your baby is showing, you will be able to assess it during the day and take action if required. If you give something to your baby at night and then put him to sleep, then your baby may have trouble digesting it also. And you may also not get to know if your baby is having any problem. So daytime is a very good time to give these meals. One meal per day is sufficient in the beginning to start with. Then the next question is what not to give to your baby. So I have already talked about what to give. So generally all the other things are what not to give category. So yeah, you should avoid giving things that have any texture. You should avoid giving things that are too thick or very, very thin or have a very bad taste. Obviously, don't give any bitter taste. Don't give karele ka juice and all that. Otherwise, your baby's experience with food will be very bad. There'll be no bonding in the beginning only. Don't give all these things. Don't give anything too hot, anything too cold. And do not give anything too heavy also, like chana dal, urad dal, arhar dal. Avoid all these things. Avoid fried things, too much of oil, ghee. Don't give anything. Give very simple food in this age. You can add things later. You can start adding ghee and other things later. At fourth month, give very, very light things to start with. Also, completely avoid giving salt and sugar till 1 year of age. Salt is not at all recommended till 1 year of age because the body's sodium requirement is very low till 1 year. And whatever requirement is there, it automatically gets fulfilled by the milk that your baby drinks or the food that your baby eats. So excess sodium over that is not at all required. It will only create a sodium load on your baby's kidneys, which can cause many complications later in life. So completely avoid giving salt. And also if you start giving salt at this age only, then your baby will not eat anything without salt because your baby will get used to that taste very, very easily. So avoid giving completely. And sugar also, sugar goes through a lot of refinement processes which make sugar very harmful for babies. And it also causes addiction to sweets. It is very easy for babies to get addicted to sugars, which can lead to obesity and again many complications. So please avoid completely. You also don't need to add jaggery and dates and other sweeteners at this age. Don't worry if your baby is not eating. Please don't think that your baby is not liking it and you have to add something to make it nicer. Don't do that. It is not required. It's just that everything is very new to your baby. It's completely fine. Don't worry and don't add all these things to food. Then the next important question is what about the milk and water schedule after baby starts with solids? So if I'm talking about milk, Please note that the milk schedule will be 97-98% the same that you were following till 4 months of age. There will hardly be any change except for the times around which your baby is eating meals, because 97-98% of body's nutritional requirement is still fulfilled by milk only. You are giving very little meal to your baby at this age, and in that also your baby may not even eat a spoon on one day. So maximum nutritional requirement is still fulfilled by milk only. The food that you're giving to your baby is only for the baby to explore, to start getting adapted to the world of foods. It is not for fulfilling all nutritional requirements. So keep your milk schedule as it is, whether you are feeding breast, formula, combination, whatever. Keep your milk schedule as it is. You can start with cow milk or buffalo milk after 1 year of age. So when you are starting solids, please continue your breastfeeding or formula feeding schedule as it was. Don't make any changes except for the time around which your baby is having the meal. Now again, there is no specific guideline for it that you have to decide depending on how much your baby has eaten. If your baby has eaten a lot of dal, maybe 5-6 spoons of dal, then obviously your baby will not feel hungry for a long time. And after that, whenever you feel your baby is ready, you can feed. And if your baby has not eaten anything at all, then of course you might need to feed a little sooner. So that only you can decide and judge depending on how much your baby needs and has eaten. So you can do it according to you. And the next thing is water. Water requirement is not very high at this age because again the baby is 97-98% on milk only, so all the water requirement gets fulfilled there. And you are also giving food in very liquid form, like a very liquidy dal, juice or thinned down puree, so water requirement is getting fulfilled. Maximum 40-50 ml of water you can give in little sips or with a spoon to your baby after meals. Maybe after dal you can give a little water, that's all. Otherwise not required. Even if your baby is not liking it and is not drinking water at all, it's all right, don't worry. The water requirement is not very high because of all the other things that the baby is having. And coming to the last point, what are the changes that you can expect in your baby after starting solids? So after starting solids, firstly, please be ready for your baby to reject completely. It is absolutely normal. Don't think that your baby did not like what you made, or your baby has some problem, or if your baby just eats and then vomits out everything, don't think that it caused some reaction in your baby or something like that. Don't worry, don't freak out at anything, unless it is obviously something very bizarre. Don't get freaked out at all these things. It is all completely normal. It is normal for your baby to love something one day and then completely reject it the next day, and vice versa also. So please don't worry. These things are all normal. Remember that the food at this age is just for your baby to have fun and explore. It is not majorly for providing nutrition. So don't worry. Whatever your baby is eating, be happy. Let your baby have fun. And you also just, you know, try to be very, very patient and persistent. And that's all. Don't worry. Another change that you can observe is in your baby's pooping schedule, or the consistency or texture of your baby's poop. So that can happen, and that can depend on the food that your baby is eating. When your baby starts eating solids, your baby may poop a little more, may poop a little less, and the color texture also can vary, which is all normal. Don't freak out. Don't worry at all. It is completely normal. It happens, unless there is a very, very different kind of smell, or the baby is having loose motions many, many times a day. Unless that is there, in that case you can consult your pediatrician. Otherwise don't worry. A slight change here and there, it is all absolutely normal. Please don't worry, please don't panic. So it is all completely normal. And these are the points that I had to discuss with you. I will be discussing all these points only for all different age groups. I hope I have covered everything. But if I have not, if I have missed anything, or if you have any specific question for me, please you can comment down below and I'll be happy to answer. And have a very good feeding journey, feeding experience. Don't rush, don't delay, be very, very relaxed about it, and let your baby enjoy the whole procedure. And you can connect with me on Instagram also. The detail of my Instagram handle is there in the description. Have a great journey and all the best to you. Bye. Thank you for watching.